I've been told that it's better to get a signed copy that doesn't have a plate, that's signed on the book and dated, so that it makes it more valuable. I collect some first editions, and so and I am
on plate. You mean inside the book or and not on?
Well, a lot of books sell. They have like a signing plate, and they paste it in.
I
so
see.
Mine, I'm requesting when, you know, I didn't succeed in using, I lost my PayPal password, which is back alive. You know, passwords, they just kill us. So, but I want everybody to go to www.lilithnovel.com and order the book. So, yeah, tell me about what Lilith looks like when she meets Don, and what Don looks like when he meets Lilith.
Okay. When they first meet, they meet in a cheese store in Bella Vista, which is the Italian market of Philadelphia. And he's of Italian, Southern Italian descent. So he's got thick, dark, kind of floppy hair, and she's got kind of ropey, dark locks. I describe it as somewhere between waves and dreadlocks. So her hair's probably how mine was when I was younger, if I wasn't brushing it. And he's wearing a sweatshirt and jeans and a pair of sneakers, and she's wearing a pair of velvet Doc Martin style boots that have an image pattern on them that look like a Van Gogh painting. And she's wearing dark jeans and a chunky chenille sweater and rings on almost every finger.
Cool.
And a big medallion.
Yeah, so she's a good-looking young lady, and he's a handsome guy.
So,
on your website, I've seen...
She's,
yeah, go ahead.
She's definitely an alter ego of mine.
Right.
And by using the Sumerian myth, by drawing from that story of Lilith not succumbing or wanting to be controlled by Adam, the two later in the book end up in a little scuffle like that, but I don't want to give too much away.
Right.
Okay,
well,
Richard.
There's exciting things coming down, and it's not a simple relationship. It's you have pieces of art on your website that are very, and photographs that are very illustrative. I mean, I love the picture of the Turkish coffee, and I love the description of the Turkish coffee was cinnamon. What are those herbs again?
Cinnamon and cardamom.
Yeah.
I love those flavors. I don't drink coffee anymore. I used to, but I do drink teas and other beverages, warm beverages that I use those spices in. It's interesting because those Turkish spices are also the ones that are used in Indian chai, and I love that. Yeah, I'm a foodie, big time foodie, and any excuse to put food in front of people, in words or actual plates, is something that I love to do. I adored the book Like Water for Chocolate. I thought that was so cool that there was a recipe at the beginning of every chapter. It's just I thought that was great. And Nick, my publisher, is a famous chef, so, you know, there you go. We love food. So it ended up there. And it's always, you know, it's a great way to show love.
Well, I love geography, like a city, like Philadelphia, and I love real restaurants and real meals and real drinks and real – are there any music groups that are in your story?
Oh, no, there's no music group, but there's real restaurant. There's a couple of real restaurants. One I'm pretty sure is still there in South Philadelphia.